Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for regular notifications.
So in this question, we have in a communication system operating at wavelength 800 nanometer, only 1% of the source frequency is available at signal bandwidth. The number of channels accommodated for transmitting TV signals of bandwidth 6 megahertz. So this is the total bandwidth available. Okay. Now wavelength, given wavelength, it is 800 nanometer. Okay. So, and velocity of wave, it is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Okay. So from this, we can calculate the frequency nu to be frequency is velocity by wavelength. So that is 3 into 10 power 8 divided by 800 nanometer. So this is 10 power minus 9. Okay. So this is on 3 by 8 into 10 power 15 hertz. Now we have to calculate the number of channels. Okay, so number of channels, see, it is given that total bandwidth is 6 megahertz, but only 1% of the source frequency is available. Now source frequency is this, so 1% of this is 1 by 100 into 3 by 8 into 10 power 15, and total bandwidth is 6 megahertz. So 6 into 10 power 6. Okay. So this, on solving, we get 6.25 into 10 power 5. Okay. So this is the total number of channels available. So option C is the correct answer. Now this is from JEE Main 2018. A telephonic communication service is working at carrier frequency of 10 gigahertz. Only 10% of it is utilized for transmission. How many telephonic channels can be transmitted simultaneously if each channel requires a bandwidth of 5 kilohertz? Okay, now this is similar to the previous problem. So here 10% of carrier frequency, that is 10% of this frequency is available. So that is 10 by 100 into 10 gigahertz. So 10 into 10 power 9. So this is 10 power 9 hertz. Okay. So this is the frequency available. Okay. So, and what is the bandwidth? 5 kilohertz. So number of channels will be 10 power 9 divided by 5 kilohertz. So this is 5 into 10 power 3. So that is 2 into 10 power 5. So of the available options, option B is the correct answer. Now next question is from JEE Main 2017. In amplitude modulation, sinusoidal carrier frequency used is denoted by omega C. Okay, this is the carrier frequency, and signal frequency is denoted by omega M. The bandwidth delta omega M of signal is such that delta omega M is very much less than omega C. Okay, so which of the following frequencies is not contained in a modulated wave? Okay, so this question is directly from NCRT. You can have a look at page number 529. Okay, so that is for amplitude modulation, if omega C is the carrier frequency, omega M is the signal frequency, then the frequencies which are contained in the modulated wave. In this question, it is asked frequencies which are not contained. So what is contained in modulated wave is omega M plus omega C minus omega M, and omega C. These are contained in the modulated wave. So what is not contained is omega M. So this option C is the correct answer. Now this is from JEE Main 2014. A transmitting antenna at the top of a tower has a height of 32 meter. So this is the height of transmitting antenna, and height of receiving antenna is 50 meter. What is the maximum distance between them for satisfactory communication in line of sight mode? Line of sight mode, LOS. Okay, LOS stand for line of sight. Okay, so that is the maximum distance we have to calculate. Now this distance, it is given by 2R. R is the radius of Earth. Height of transmitting antenna, square root of this, plus 2R, height of receiving antenna. Now in this question, height of transmitting antenna is given, height of receiving antenna is also given. Okay, and this radius of Earth, it is 6400 kilometers, so that is into 10^3 meter. Okay, so now if you substitute these values, given values over here, this D max value comes to be around 45.5 kilometer. So from the given options, option B is the correct answer.